Hello guys, and welcome back to another video of Architects 3DP. In this video, I'm gonna show you some fans that I bought a while ago, and I'm very happy with the performance I have experienced so far. The fans are the Noctua NF-A4x10 FLX and NF-A4x20 FLX. Noctua did not sponsor this video, and I paid the full price on Amazon to buy them, so don't think I'm being paid for saying good stuff about them. I'm gonna make the unboxing of both products, and I'm gonna prepare an installation video in the CTC Prusa i3 Pro B for next week. But before starting, make sure you're subscribed to our YouTube channel, clicking here in this little icon in the bottom right corner of the video. If you do it, you will help me creating new content and growing the channel to reach more special viewers like you. Okay, so as you can see, I've bought three fans, an NF-A4x20 FLX and two NF-A4x10 FLX. I'm gonna use the 20mm one for the layer cooling and the two 10mm ones to cool down the electronics and the nozzle. As I said before, I bought them from Amazon for a price of €12.90 for the 10mm version and €15.35 for the 20mm one. Despite you can find very cheap alternatives on Amazon, eBay or other online shops even from 1 euro, I have tested some of them, but after 1 or 2 weeks they start making weird noises and so on. With the Noctua ones, besides the incredible performance, they offer a 6-year warranty, what makes this small investment worth it for a very long time. Starting with the boxes, they come very well packed, and my first impression is that it is a high quality box made for a high quality product. If we continue with the Noctua NF-A4x10 FLX, we can see that the box opens like a book in both sides. On the front, it shows a view of the products and all the included components on the right hand side, and some sketches about the improved design on the left. The case opens on the back as well, where they put a lot of information about the design and the included components. As a summary, the fans have flow acceleration channels on the blades, what provides better efficiency and lower vortex noise. They also reduce the motor hub size compared to other 4mm fans, so the airflow and the pressure are significantly better. The Noctua's AAO frame will keep the vibrations controlled, improving low noise and performance. Other features are the stepped inlet design, the inner surface microstructures, and the integrated anti-vibration pads, which together will improve the efficiency, performance, and low noise of the fans. In the right-hand side, they talk about the new drive they use, the sealed bearings, and all the cable extensions included in the box. But now we're gonna see what's inside. After opening the box, the first we find is a small transparent bag with something inside. Once we open it, we can see that it includes the OmniJoin adapter set. With it, we'll be able to connect our fan to any plug that our 3D printer uses. It includes four of what they call 3M Touch Lock connectors, but it's very handy to join the cables if you don't want to start welding. Next, we find a 30cm extension cable that is properly sleeved and with a nice finish. We of course can also find the nice Noctua NF-A4x10 FLX fan that has a 20cm properly sleeved cable and a nice design as you can see. Next, we'll find what they call a low noise adapter, what is a properly sleeved cable with a resistance that will reduce the RPM of our fan from 4500 to 3700, and we're gonna use to cool down the electronics of the printer. We also have the 3-to-2 pin adapter, one more time properly sleeved and with a quality finish, another transparent bag with 4 screws to attach the fan to the case, and finally the 4 anti-vibration mounts that you can use instead of the screws, and will help reducing the vibrations as well. As you can see, it's a very complete packaging for less than 13 bucks. Jumping to the Noctua NF-A4x20 FLX fan, the 20mm version of the fan, we find a very similar unboxing experience with some difference that I'm gonna detail now. The information in the box is mostly the same, with a difference that this one is twice as thick as the 10mm version we saw before, what will increase the static pressure performance, making this fan ideal for demanding applications with high flow resistance, such as the fan duct I'm using for the layer cooling. When we open the box, we find pretty much the same stuff than before, but we also find some different components. The anti-vibration mounts now are bigger, since this fan is twice as fat as before. The fan itself, one more time, includes a properly sleeved 20cm cable, and you can notice how wide this fan is compared to the 10mm version. With the original cable, the fan will spin at 5000 RPM, while with the low noise adapter, reduce the RPM to 4400 with the ultra low noise adapter, the RPM will be reduced to 3700, making it incredibly silent. We're not going to use these two adapters, since we're gonna need full power for the layer cooling, but it's nice to have them. Finally, we find the two transparent boxes we opened before, with the four screws and the OmniJoin adapter set to connect our fan with any plug our board uses. Okay, so that's it for the unboxing of these amazing Noctua fans that you can use in any 3D printer. If you make a quick research on Thinkiverse, you will find a lot of 3D printed adapters to install the fans in your machine. In the next video, I will install the three fans in my CTC Prusa i3 Pro B 3D printer and show you the whole process that you can follow for your machine. I have added affiliate links to buy the fans from Amazon from every different country down in the description, as well as the link to buy the CTC Prusa i3 Pro B that I will install the fans on. A 99 euros 3D printer kit that will perfectly introduce you in the 3D printing world. If you buy the products from the links, you will help the channel with a small percentage of the price you pay for the fans. Okay guys, so buy a lot of Noctua fans and 3D printers from the links in the description, because that has been everything for this video. Now stay tuned for the new content in the upcoming weeks, hit the like button, share the video, leave a comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel clicking here in this little icon. You can also follow us on social networks at Architects3DP to get the latest news, and please consider supporting my work on Patreon to keep making this channel possible. Besides helping us and making us super happy, you will also get nice rewards that you can check in our Patreon's page, navigating to patreon.com/architects3dp or clicking in the link in the description. Okay, so as always, see you in the next video.